error analysis for the midpoint method. So we use our function we've been using over the interval we've been using, and the actual integral is equal to this number. Now, the midpoint values are just for an n size of 5, are not too bad, a little bit off there. By the time you get to 500, 6.4377 matches up pretty good. So it's a pretty good method. Well, let's see how it compares with the trapezoid, which was a second power method. Let's just see what this is. So this right here, when you go from 5 to 50, that's a factor of 10 increase in the n size. You go from basically 0.1, that's 0.09, that's 0.1, to 0.001. So you've gone down by a factor of 100. In other words, you've divided this number by 100 to get to this number. And then to get to this number, when you've upped the n size by another factor of 10, you go down another two zeros right there. So that's dividing by 100 again. So it's going down by a factor of 100. And then when you go from here to here, looks like you have six zeros there. So you've gone down another factor of 100, and here you have eight zeros. So it looks like it's the same as the trapezoid method, as increases by a factor of 10, the error decreases by a factor of 100. So we get a resulting increase in accuracy that is the second power, the square of the processing work we put in the first place. Okay, so I've written down in a box here what we have so far for these methods. The left and right method are first power methods, meaning that if you increase the n size by a factor of k, then that decreases the error by a factor of k to the first power. So we've been using factors of 10, but I'm going to assign you some problems where we don't go up by a factor of 10, maybe we go up by a factor of 6. And then we'll see that that decreases the error by a factor of 6, if k was 6. And moving on to the, moving on to the trap and mid, here, we found out that those are second power methods, meaning that if we increase n by a factor of k, that decreases the error by a factor of k squared. We've been using 10 as the factor of increase. But, like I said, we could use 6, 7, 20, any kind of factor. And this rule would hold. You would see in the data, and we're going to have some problems on this, that if you increase the n by any factor, k, then your error goes down by k squared factor for the trap and the mid. So there are a lot better methods than the left and the right.